Thanks, Jess. Okay, good morning, everyone. I'm Wayne Ewasko. I'm the Minister of Advanced Education, Skills and Immigration for the province of Manitoba. On behalf of Premier Calvin Goertzen and my colleague, Minister Gordon, I welcome all of you to the sunny blue skies in great town of Beausejour today for this announcement. I would like to acknowledge that we here in Manitoba are on Treaties 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 lands, which are the traditional lands and territories of the Anishinaabe, Cree, Oji-Cree, Dakota, and Dene peoples, and the homeland of the Métis Nation. It is a pleasure to be here in Beausejour again with my friend and colleague, Minister Gordon, who is the Minister of Health and Seniors Care, and also the Minister of Mental Health, Wellness, and Recovery. So welcome to the town of Beausejour, Minister Gordon. Today we are joined by Dr. Myron Thiessen, who is the site manager, chief medical manager for the Beausejour Hospital here, and also Dr. Mathieu, who is the CEO for the Interlake-Eastern Regional Health Authority. We're also joined here by Dr. Alexandra Wood, who is right behind me, who is a residency program graduate for this important announcement. And of course, we have Dr. Myron Thiessen to my left, who is the regional lead medical services lead for the Interlake Eastern Regional Health Authority. Also within the crowd, we are joined by Ruth Ann Fergala, who is the vice chair for the Interlake Eastern Regional Health Authority, Dr. Joseph Partica, who is the who I've already mentioned, but he's the chief medical officer here for the hospital of the Beausejour Hospital. We have Amber Reichert, who is the clinical team manager also for the Beausejour Hospital. We also have with us today, we have His Worship Mayor Ray Sherrill for the town of Beausejour. We have the Reeve for the RM of Brokenhead, Mr. Brad Saluk. We have town councillors. We have Candice Holograski, Jan LeClaire, Glenn Cates, and Don Mazur. So with that, I'd like to thank everybody that I've just mentioned for joining us here for this very important announcement here in Beausejour. Our government understands the importance of supporting internationally educated individuals. We understand that in order to invest in our communities and provide quality primary care, we have to recruit and retain the best people for the job. Today I would like to announce that 9 new medical graduates will be practicing or are already practicing family physicians in the Interlake Eastern Regional Health Authority. These 9 family physicians are in addition to the 4 family medical medicine residents completing their training in the region right now. Of these 9 family physicians, 4 of them are graduates of the Medical Licensure Program for International Medical Graduates Program from the University of Manitoba. This program is designed to enhance the current skills of internationally educated family physicians. Recruitment efforts allow these new physicians the opportunity to better understand the needs for our rural patients and the variety of services they will be able to offer their community. These 9 graduates have not only made the decision to practice right here in Manitoba, but to set up their practice in rural communities where they will stay to build their careers and provide quality care to area residents. This announcement reiterates our continued commitment to promote student success, advancing international education, and continuing to foster partnerships within the industry. I will now turn it over to my colleague, Minister Audrey Gordon. But before I do, I just want to say thank you to these new graduates. Thank you for making the decision to build your careers in rural Manitoba, and thank you for providing quality health care to Manitobans. I'll turn it over to Minister Gordon now.
Thank you, Minister Ewasko, and good morning to everyone here today. Thank you for joining us at this special announcement this morning, and the skies are certainly blue over Beausejour. It's a beautiful day to be here, and looking forward to driving around a little bit in the community before we head back to Winnipeg. I want to thank again my colleague Wayne Ewasko. We sit very close to each other in the chamber. Don't know where we'll be in October when we go back into session, but I certainly enjoyed being sworn into office with Minister Ewasko back in January. Also want to welcome Dr. David Mateer, CEO of the Interlake Regional Health Authority, Dr. Myron Thiessen, and Dr. Alexandra Wood for being here today. Our government is committed to ensuring quality primary care for rural Manitobans. We're committed to attracting and retaining family physicians to support consistent and reliable healthcare services. With today's announcement of 9 new physicians in the Interlake-Eastern region, we are ensuring rural Manitobans receive quality primary care. These physicians will be working in rural and underserviced areas of our province. When we train family physicians in rural communities, we expose them to both the benefits and specific challenges of providing health care to smaller communities while also ensuring the primary care that Manitobans deserve. Recruitment efforts by the region and private clinics will see new physicians begin practice in Beausejour, Eriksdale, Lac-Dubonnet, Toulon, and Selkirk, with internationally experienced medical graduates working in Ashern and Pine Falls. These recruitment programs are designed to help medical residents learn from the wide variety of communities in the region and address a wide range of healthcare needs, from prevention to chronic disease management and across the full continuum of care, including community health, hospital-based care, and palliative care. This announcement and our ongoing physician recruitment and retention efforts are part of our government's commitment to providing quality health care to all Manitobans. Thank you to all 9 physicians who have made the choice to practice in rural Manitoba and provide excellent primary care right here at home. We are so glad to have you, and on behalf of our government, I wish you all the best in your practice. Thank you.
Thank you, Minister Gordon, and I will now like to invite Dr. Myron Thiessen, the Regional Lead Medical Services for Interlake-Eastern Regional Health Authority, and the CMO, the Chief Medical Officer, to share a few words with us. Myron? Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Minister Ewasko, Minister Gordon, Mayor and Reeve and all other honored guests, good morning. I am very pleased to be here to acknowledge the collective work that has been done to bring new family medicine practitioners to the Interlake-Eastern Regional Health Authority. Family physicians work as a part of healthcare teams that provide people with access to primary healthcare. They are also responsible for things such as taking call in rural emergency departments, taking care of inpatients, delivering babies, and providing care to personal care home residents. There is a lot expected of physicians rurally, but a career in rural practice offers many rewards. The announcement today represents provincial, regional, and local community partnerships that all benefit the recruitment of doctors to the region. Provincially, the International Medical Graduate Program and the physicians who participate in this program are essential components of our care teams in the underserviced areas of our region. I want to welcome Dr. Tanyang and Dr. Chumber to Ashern, and Drs. Gendy and Kerr Ramsey to Powerview Pine Falls. Regionally, among the physicians joining our team are the first two physicians, Drs. Wood and Hebert, to complete residency training in the Interlake-Eastern Regional Health Authority. This is a real testament to the recruitment potential of rural residency programs. I'd like to thank Dr. Ian Alexander, who practices in Selkirk, for his vision and support of the residency program in the region, as well as other physicians and staff in the region who serve as mentors to physician learners through the residency program. We look forward to continuing work with Dr. Wood and Hebert, and I extend our thanks to them on behalf of the region for choosing to continue to practice in the Interlake-Eastern RHA. Locally, there are private practice physicians, Dr. Bruno, who practices in Lac Da Bani, and Dr. Loudon, who practices in Toulon, who have made personal investments in mentoring students. These investments have paid off with the addition of new physicians, Dr. Danakis to the care team in Toulon, and Dr. Klovachuk to the team in Lac Da Bani. In Ericsdale, we have Dr. Young joining our physician team. Dr. Young is originally from the Ericsdale area, and that speaks to the importance of local community partnerships. I also want to thank the residents of the region for the warm welcome they offered to care providers starting practice in the Interlake-Eastern RHA. We have to acknowledge that the people of this region are a big part of why doctors want to work and deliver care here. Combined, we are all working towards our mutually agreed upon goal of developing a skilled and dedicated workforce, and that includes the physicians who are a part of our care teams. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Thiessen, and all of the staff of the Interlake-Eastern Regional Health Authority. I would like to now invite Dr. Alexandra Wood, a residency program graduate and a new family physician in the Interlake-Eastern Health Region, to say a few words. Dr. Wood?
Hello, everyone, and good morning. I'm Dr. Alexandra Wood, and I'm a recent graduate of the University of Manitoba Medical School and the Interlake-Eastern Regional Health Authority Family Medicine Residency Program. I grew up just outside of Winnipeg in the town of Birds Hill, but I have visited family in Beausejour and Selkirk many times, and I've become familiar with the communities. On Tuesday, I will start my practice at the Selkirk Medical Clinic, where I've completed my residency. Although I was exposed to other parts of the region as well, including Lac Da Bani. I am one of the first to graduate from this new family medicine residency program, and I was invited to share a little bit about my experience with the residency and why I decided to practice in this region. I became interested in the rural healthcare originally during Home for the Summer, where I was actually completed two summers here in Beausejour a few years ago. Home for the Summer really gives medical students a hands-on clinical experience through job shadowing roles. I thank all of the doctors and staff from Beausejour as well as the other surrounding communities when I was a student. I have learned a lot about family medicine and working rurally from those practitioners. I wanted to do my residency rurally because of the wide variety of exposures to different types of medicine. I love that I can care for patients from birth to their elderly stages of life. The program was excellent, and I can't thank Dr. Alexander, our program lead, enough for his guidance and expertise while starting out as a new physician. As a resident, we were able to gain exposure to the areas that interest us most. For me, I have a special interest in addictions medicine, and I was able to attend the Rapid Access to Addiction Medicine in Selkirk and gain experience working with patients there. This is something I hope to carry forward in my clinical practice. I've been very grateful for the opportunity to work in a region where I've already developed connections with other practitioners and even some of my patients through the Family Medicine Residency Program. I look forward to starting my practice on Tuesday. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Wood, for those remarks and sharing a little bit of your own personal experience and story about your journey to start practicing. And good luck this coming Tuesday. Welcome to the region. We know that you're going to definitely be an asset for many, many years to come. So as usual, I'd like to, at the same time, thank our media for making the trek out to Bozizhzhir. It's not that far of a drive, but we do appreciate the media coming. What we're going to do is we're going to wrap this up. We're going to open it up to some questions, and then we're going to get together for a bit of a group photo as well. So that concludes this morning's announcement, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you very much for attending.